I used everyday items and no special tools to make this mini cash register with a working handle and drawer. I drew a circle with a 1.5 inch diameter onto some foam core. I'm cutting straight up and down so the edges are straight and not angled. I'm cutting my circle into 4 even pieces. I traced one of the wedges onto more foam core and cut a 5th piece so the register will be wide enough. I traced each end onto cereal box and capped each side. I'm covering all the texture and unevenness of the foam core with cereal box. I folded the cereal box so I can cover the back and the front curve with the same piece. I like to attach a piece that's too big and then cut it to be the perfect size. I want this to look like a fancy antique register, so I'm using more pieces of cereal box to add details. I added 4 rows of thin cereal box and capped off the top of the rows. I cut 2 pieces of cereal box slightly bigger than the base. I made a space for a drawer to slide into, leaving the front open. For the drawer, I cut a rectangle of cereal box and added 4 short sides. I made sure it'll fit into the space I just made. I'm dry fitting the drawer to make sure the bottom fits and the drawer works. Then I glued the bottom in place. I attached a larger rectangle to act as the drawer front. I added a skinny strip of cereal box to each side, leaving some overhang. I'll add more detail between the 2 strips later. I gave the register a coat of yellow ochre paint, and now I'm adding more detail using lace. The old cash registers that are inspiring this project have a really nice, fancy, engraved quality. Gluing lace to the surface is a great way to mimic that texture. I'm cutting up a couple different lace ribbons I have and using white glue to apply it. I created a border around the drawer using this rope string from a price tag. I added lace to the cereal box strips on the front and the sides. To make my metallic paint pop, I painted the entire register with a base coat of yellow ochre covered with gold paint. Once you add the paint, it unifies the different materials and it really does look like engraved metal. You could use this technique to mimic carved wood by painting it brown and other wood tones. This step's a little scary because I already like how this looks, but to emphasize all of the different textures, I'm adding a bit of black wash. This is just watered down black acrylic paint. I'm using some sewing pins to create rows of buttons. I cut 12 in total and I'm covering them with a mixture of black paint and white glue. I used a little bit of white glue to push them into the holes I made. To make the window that displays the price, I traced a couple shapes onto some more cereal box. There are 2 pieces layered on top of one another. To make it look like there's a price being displayed on the window, I cut out a graphic from a magazine and glued it to a piece of cereal box painted black. I'm gluing some trash plastic over top of it to make it look like it's covered with glass. In order to make the glue disappear, I need to entirely cover this piece with glue and then squish my plastic into place. To make the handle for the register, I traced a shape onto some more cereal box. This will be a working handle, so I'm adding some super glue to make it stronger. I stuck a sewing pin through one of the ends and painted the entire handle with a coat of gray paint covered with silver. I'm covering it with some black wash so it doesn't look brand new. These fancy toothpicks are my new best friend, and I'm using one of them to create the fancy wooden part of the handle. I cut off the very end of the toothpick so I can round it. I'm removing the hard edges so it would be nice and comfy for a miniature hand. I stuck it to some tape for easy handling, and I'm staining it with watered down brown paint. I inserted the pin into the foam core so the handle goes back and forth and looks like it works. I'm using a combination of markers and paint to add colors to the buttons. I colored the buttons with the markers and then painted over top of it with white. The marker bleeds through the paint and creates a subtle color. I'm adding the tiniest dab of Diamond Glaze to each button to give them dimension and make them really shiny. I paid $1 on Etsy to print out this cash money. I really wanted to find French money since I'll be using this register in a French boutique, but I didn't find any. I'm using my glue stick and folding each of the bills in half so they have a front and back. Some of you may have detected my editing trickery and noticed the cash register looks a little different. I wanted the drawer to have more projection, so I remade the lower part. Instead of having the drawer start directly below the top part of the register, I created a larger bottom piece so it has projection and a small ledge. I reused the drawer and created new sides and new bottoms. I attached the lace before assembling the bottom.